We love it. Keeping it, that's the problem, though. Keeping that money. Welcome back. 941, 47 degrees outside. Les Szarka's here. That can mean only one thing. Talking finances, and specifically this week, we had that huge crash in China. They actually had their circuit breakers
twice.
Shut off.
Yeah, twice.
Monday and Thursday that happened.
Right.
Man, what is going on over there?
Well, they've got some structural problems that are coming home to roost. These aren't new problems. These aren't, you know, this is anything that, you know, is surprising people. It's just that we've chosen to ignore it. The markets have chosen to ignore it, you know, for a couple of years now. So a lot of those problems are starting to come home to roost. And they, you know, their stock market is in its infancy stage, kind of like where we were back in the 20s.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah,
so this is
this is
like a new game to them, you know. And so they had a tremendous run up in 14. I mean, tremendous run up and part of 15. And then they, you know, people realize, well, it goes the other way. And so when that happened, they panicked. And so we, you know, they've seen some tremendous losses in China. And so now you're looking at, you know, are the Chinese citizens going to come back into the marketplace, having, you know, given the experience they just went through? So we'll see. You know,
and of course, that trickles over to us because we saw a little bit of a hit, you know, Thursday into Friday, a little bit of a rebound on Friday, but
this last week, and then actually it started the last couple of days in December too. So we're down right now. We're down about 7%. We're down about 10% from the May high. So we're flirting with what's called correction territory. So if the market's down 10, we're in a correction. If it's down 20, it's a bear market. So we're in correction territory right now. We've been there twice now, just more recently. Last August, we were down 10%.
Right.
And then about 15 months ago, we were down 10%. Both times we rebounded. This time, who knows? There's a lot more bad news that's circulating right now. It's not just China. Obviously, the Middle East is in, you know, I mean,
right.
They have a huge hot mess out going out there, especially now with Saudi Arabia being a little bit more aggressive. You're looking at Canada, Mexico, and Japan are already in recessions. So globally, we're in a pretty big slowdown. And then now the talk about us going into a recession for this year is heating up. So it's not a surprise that the market's down.
But it is maybe a surprise to people who are a little curious about their money. They're like, well, you know, what should I do? Should I?
Yeah, it's not curious. They're scared.
Well, yeah. I was trying to be nice, low, and trying to ease it a little bit in, but yeah.
Yeah, there's definitely some angst out there right now. And honestly, you have to look at, it depends on what position you're starting from. If you're really heavily in stocks right now, 80, 90%, then yeah, I would worry. Because this thing could definitely deteriorate more, and this could finally be that 20, 25% correction that we've been anticipating now for a couple years. If you're light in stocks, I don't know if I'd start buying yet. I would probably wait until we get to like the middle of next week and just see where things shake out. There might be some better opportunities to jump back in, you know, in the coming days, weeks, you know, maybe even month or so. So it really depends on what your starting point is.
Okay.
I'm definitely not in panic mode, but if you're heavily in stocks, I would be careful because this thing could get uglier before it gets better.
We got this big Powerball tonight.
Oh yeah, did you get your ticket?
Million. I got my ticket.
But you know what? Think about it. It's 800 million.
Right.
They only give you a lump sum of 400.
Right.
After government gets their share, you got 220 million. Is it really worth buying the ticket?
220
million?
I don't know. I guess it's just pocket change when you think about it. No, but if you get that money, you know, people are like, well, I'm gonna buy all this and do all this. If somebody happens to win here and they call you up, what's your first piece of advice for them?
Well, if Gabe Spiegel was still here,
he would want gold.
Gold,
right,
absolutely.
Of course, because
yeah,
Gabe
be
loves
buying.
Gold. We know that.
Yes, we know.
Gabe always talks about gold.
I give him the same advice. I would just, you know, keep your powder dry. You know, I mean, you know, when you got that much money, you're not going to outlive it. So then it's a matter of, you know, how do I best use this over my lifetime, my kids' generation, my grandkids' generation? So it's not so much of an investment question. It's more how do I best utilize, you know, this blessing that I got, you know, to help other folks out as well.
Well, if you don't happen to win the lottery and you do have some financial questions, call Les.
Yeah, you can still call.
Yeah. Szarka Financial, 29691 Lorraine Road, North Olmsted, especially with the markets the way they are. If they start making a big shift, Les obviously will be able to help you out with that. Are we still doing the book thing?
Oh, yeah, the book's doing very well. And we talk about this in the book as well in terms of how to get through these periods of time where, you know, you're tempted to sell or you're tempted to do something that may be not in your best interest. So, yeah, there's a couple chapters in that actually talk about that.
That psychology, the book.
The whole psychology.
Money Talks and, of course, Money Brain, which
Money
is the
Brain
other book
the
that Les has.